A similar kind of attraction of opposite charges occurs when you rub a balloon against hair. Friction dislodges or moves free electrons from the hair onto the balloon, making the balloon more negative as it collects the electrons. Moving the balloon close to the hair again causes the hair to move toward the balloon, since the hair, having lost electrons to the balloon, is now less negative and therefore more positive. If we put the balloon against a wall, it will stick because the negative ions on the balloon are attracted to the neutral or less negatively charged wall. But electrons don't move to the wall because the wall covering is not a conductor of electricity. The first part of Coulomb's law, like charges repel, can be demonstrated with a Van de Graaff generator, which is a charge separator. A Van de Graaff generator is somewhat like a mechanical Leyden jar, the same kind of device that led to Franklin's discovery of lightning as electricity. As the rubber belt moves, it collects electrons from the comb of the generator and deposits them on the sphere. Some of these electrons also transfer to the paper strips on the sphere. Eventually, the paper strips will rise away as the negative electrons on the paper are repelled by the negative electrons on the sphere. As the charge continues to build up on the sphere, it begins to discharge through the air, and we can see and hear the same little strokes of lightning that led Ben Franklin to propose his kite experiment, an experiment that led the way to the development of the science of electricity itself, the science that is responsible for the lightning in our lives.